once we have finished our preliminary gating from our flow stability, single cells, our Schmutz removal gate, and our live cells, we can start to do gating to identify our target cells of interest. And that involves using the antibodies that we labeled our cells with. So if we go from our live cells, we're going to be looking at a CD3 versus side scatter. And what we identify as our CD3 positive cells here. Now, I could do CD3 versus CD4, but I tend to like to do CD3 by itself because oftentimes I do CD4 and CD8 together. In this case, we're not. So we have our CD4 gate shown here. The third gate here we are going to then go to is our identification of our regulatory T cells based upon expression of FOXP3 and CD25. CD25 on the y-axis, FOXP3 on the x-axis. Let me close these out for a minute. So this is in our experimental sample. We have our workflow. Now in our FMO sample, we have CD25 FMO and a FOXP3 FMO. You'll notice that these have also gone through the same gating strategy where we've applied Flow AI to identify the good cells. And we're down here to our final population. These is our CD25 FMO control. So these, this population, this sample does not contain any CD25. And then we have down here our FOXP3 sample, which again does not contain any FOXP3. So I'm just going to put that here so you can see them. When I'm using FMO controls, I'm going to gate on the full population, the full sample here first to identify my target cells. Then I'm going to apply that to my two FMO controls and refine the gate based upon that. So here, we're going to look at this population and I'm comfortable with putting my lower bound about here. Cut through there. We'll bring up. I'll call these Tregs. So there's a small percentage of the cells. Now, what we're going to go to is all samples just for a minute. We're going to find our Treg population and we're going to apply that to both of the FMO controls shown here. And now we're going to compare the FMO controls to ensure that we're setting the gate in the correct position. Now, I will do this sometimes by using quadrant gates, which help me identify and set as targets. So here I'm going to set a quadrant gate kind of in the background here. These are FOXP3 negative. So we know this line here is comfortable for us to say the cells above that are positive, FOXP3 positive. We can then apply that quadrant gating structure to our other Treg. And now we see here what we're going to be focusing on is adjusting the gate to the CD25. You'll notice that there's some the negative population is spread over a bit. So we're going to refine our gate a little bit more to this population here. And you'll see our FOXP3 gate, positive gate, is tight here. We have this little space here. We could bring this down a bit, but if we reapply this quadrants that we defined down here and then bring those to our full sample, I'll delete them after I've done this. We see that there's a small population above, so this population based upon this signal should probably go up a bit, but this signal appears to be nice and tight on the axis here. So I'm comfortable with this gate. The other thing I'm going to look at when I'm doing my gating in my FMO is in a population, the number of events or the percent population in this gate. Based upon a normal distribution, -3 and +3 standard deviations contains 99.5% of the data. That means 0.25% of the data, or 0.25%, is above 3 standard deviations and 0.25% is below three standard deviations. So I tend to set this so that my gate is at, there's no more than 0.1% of the population of my FMOs in this gate. And that's how I can explain and give you another way using statistics is to make sure that your gate is set correctly and that you're not bringing in extraneous populations. You can set that at any level you wish. For example, in phosphoproteins, they tend to use two standard deviations above the mean. But here we're using beyond three. With that, we've now got our populations, and we can then go into extracting information from about our regulatory T cells and characterizing them in greater detail based upon our experimental design, capture enough information to then go and do statistical analysis.